Hi everyone, I'm Thomas Pesquet and I'm an astronaut for the European Space Agency. Later this year, I'll be living and working on board the International Space Station, the ISS, orbiting the Earth at 28,000 kilometers per hour and seeing 16 sunrises and 16 sunsets every day. My mission is named Proxima, and during its 6 months duration, I'll be conducting cutting-edge research enabled by the space environment. The ISS is indeed a laboratory where microgravity enables us to make discoveries or observe physical phenomena that would forever be inaccessible on Earth. We study biology, material science, fluid physics, physiology and medicine, Earth and environment science, and much, much more. We are indeed the operators of scientific experiments and hardware, but we are also very often the guinea pigs. And by studying the effects of microgravity on our own bodies, we understand better the processes of aging, the intricate work of the human brain, the science of vaccines and viruses. The ISS is also a stepping stone on a longer road to exploration. We learn to live in space, in the vicinity of the Earth, so that in a not so distant future, we'll be able to go further into space and answer deeper questions about the origin of life, to learn about the past, but also glimpse into the future of the human race. On that very special journey of 6 months away from the planet, there's not so much room for personal luggage. A few pictures of my loved ones, some music, special food that I like, but I managed to make room for a copy of the COP21 agreement that French President François Hollande handed to me in December last year. It is already packed and it's ready to be shipped to the ISS as we speak. It is a symbol for France and I hope a symbol for the world. For the first time in 20 years of UN negotiations, countries have agreed to commit. This agreement is the first step in fighting climate change and its impacts, an objective that the 193 countries of the United Nations have also agreed to as Sustainable Development Goal, or SDG number 13, in the UN 2030 agenda. Urgent action is needed. While we are waiting, climate target doors are closing. Limiting the rise in average global temperature to 2 degrees and protecting the most vulnerable require efforts from all. The role of science in fighting climate change is essential, especially in monitoring climate variables and assessing mitigation and adaptation scenarios. And that's why I wanted to talk to you today. The ISS is a fantastic Earth observation platform, and space has a huge role to play. Of the 50 essential climate variables, 26 are observed only from space. Satellites in space and humans on the ISS can measure precisely sea level rise, temperature change. They can quantify melting ice at the poles, and they can perform global measurements of greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, and so much more. In the future, the measurements will be more and more precise and more local so that we can track and enforce from space the agreements taken on Earth by the countries. At a more personal level, seeing planet Earth from space makes you take a huge step back and realize how fragile it is with your own eyes, how thin is our atmosphere. All the life forms that we know of, the entire biodiversity in the infinity of space around us, are contained within an unbelievably thin layer of gases on a very small and isolated planet in the global darkness and emptiness of the cosmic void. So beyond my technical work on board the ISS, I want to help people on Earth realize that they too live on a spaceship journeying in the solar system, the spaceship planet Earth, a much bigger one than mine, but one that also has limited resources, a spaceship with a much bigger crew, a crew of 7 and some billion members, but a crew that also has to get along to keep the journey safe. spaceship that in the end we have to take care of so that the journey continues for a very, very long time. So I thank you for your attention, and I'll see you again from space.